As announced in my last video, I tested a collection of 29 microswitch pairs in terms of the force required to actuate them and at the sound they produce. The former is objective data, thanks to this perfectly calibrated digital force gauge meter, as can be seen with my iPhone 5. On the other hand, the latter is subjective data, because what pleases my ears may not please yours, but you will be the judge. As an example, consider the standard switches on this hot-swappable mouse, an Asus Keris. These two tiny little things are rated for 70 million clicks, and their most common gram force, aka mode, is 58 and 64, respectively. Since the difference between these values is 6 gram force, I deem their consistency to be bad. Why do I think this information is important, even though I only have two samples? Because most people would buy a single pair, and not a dozen, just to be the perfect one. Moving on, since the average of these values is 61 gram force, they offer a medium to medium light click feel. As for their sound, let's take a listen. Pretty average, I'd say. But always bear in mind that the sound of a microswitch is heavily influenced by the specific mouse it's in. Now, let's reiterate such tests on all the remaining 28 pairs, with one exception. I couldn't record the sound of the Panasonic because its base is too wide to fit into the socket, and I didn't want to alter it by sending it down. Anyhow, please enjoy the current audio-video sequences. Thank you. And there you go! For your convenience and ease of reading, here's a summary split into two parts. On the first slide is the Noctua Huano, silent yellow, which deserves my gold medal for its sound, or lack thereof. I don't know how they did it, but it's really soft. On the second slide, while my silver medal goes to the Jabron F37 for its exceptional lightness, my bronze medalist is the Defond 2310. It has arguably the quirkiest sound of them all, but in a good way. Therefore, I would encourage you to buy a hot-swappable mouse too, so you can try and find the microswitch that best suits your preferences and needs. I've linked some in this video description, but there are more in the wild. Or you could simply make your current mouse hot-swappable, but that's a story for another time. Many thanks for your support, and fare you well for now.